No walkouts.
Či je to gin tonic, prosím? Johnny, is this your drink?
I don't know.
I'm not sure.
Is it my drink?
Okay.
Is it my drink?
How would I know?
I don't know. I was just wondering.
She'll know.
It's definitely your drink.
Ona to pozná, to je jeho.
It's my drink.
It's his drink.
So most of you left. No, I'm kidding.
Většina z vás odešla. Ne, dělám si legraci.
Victoria. Jak se daří Shaneovi?
Victoria, how is Shane doing?
How long have you got?
Kolik máme času?
Asi půl hodiny.
30 minutes.
20 minutes.
30.
I think he's genuinely very, 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 very happy that you guys are showing this film, because he loves this country, and particularly he loves Prague. He loves Czech beer. If he was here, he'd probably be going to the beer bath, which we're going to go to in his honor. We're going to go to the beer bath. Yes, we are. And he's very grateful, especially to Julian, because even though he's a slimy limey, can you translate that?
I'm a Brit bastard.
So, Brit bastard. He pulled off a really beautiful film. Beautiful.
About a beautiful man.
By a beautiful man. Julian is a beautiful man who made a beautiful film.
About a beautiful man.
And Stephen is also very beautiful, and he doesn't get enough credit. Because he's like...
Victoria, I'm sorry.
On je opravdu rád, má opravdu obrovitánskou radost, že se ten film tady promítá, protože má tuhle zemi rád, má rád Prahu, má rád české pivo. My jsme mu říkali, že půjdeme do pivní lázní, na což se opravdu chystáme, a toho taky potěšilo. A je opravdu vděčný Julianovi. On je to takový bručoun, ale natočil krásný film. A Julian říká, ano, je to krásný film o krásném člověku.
Well done.
Johnny,
really good.
Round of applause.
Yes.
Jak jste se potkali se Shaneem?
Johnny, how did you get to meet Shane?
Pamatuješ si váš první drink?
Do you remember your first drink together?
Yes. I remember it very well. I remember it better than Shane does.
Ano, já se to pamatuju hodně dobře. Já pamatuju si to líp než Shane.
Don't trust that guy. He doesn't like.
Nevěřte mu.
He doesn't remember so.
Perfect recall.
On neví, co povídá.
I was with a There was a dear friend of mine named Jerry Conlon, who, in fact, they made a film about his life called In the Name of the Father. And Jerry Conlon and I somehow became close. And he said, we were in England. He said, I must take you to Ireland. So we went to Ireland together. But before we went to Ireland, I'd spoken about Shane McGowan and what a hero he had always been as a songwriter, certainly, but as a poet and a man, you know. And then we met Victoria. And I was brought into a recording studio, I believe, and my first glimpse of Shane was in this hand he had a guitar, an acoustic guitar. He was sitting on a pool table, you know, a billiard table, and he had a guitar in this hand and a pint of beer in this hand.
Czech beer. It was definitely Czech beer.
And it was one of those moments where you don't know if he's going to look at you and go, hello? Or potentially, you know, smash the pint against you. You just didn't know. He's a very unpredictable animal. And then we re-met the next day through Victoria again, and it just, I don't know, it sparked off something very special, and I'm proud to to say that even though from the first second that I met Shane, my instant fear was, he doesn't have 2 weeks, man. He's not going to make it. It was over 30 years ago, man. He should be studied forever. That was my first experience with Shane, yeah.
Ano, to se odehrálo v souvislosti se setkáním s Jerrym Conlanem. Natáčel se film o jeho životě, ve jménu otce. A my jsme si nakonec byli velice blízcí, byli jsme přátelé. Já jsem byl v Anglii, setkali jsme se, on říkal, já tě musím vzít do Irska. A ještě předtím, než jsme jeli, tak jsem mluvil o Shaneovi jako o skvělém písničkáři, o básníkovi jako o skvělém člověku. A potom jsme se potkali s Viktorií a vzali nás do takového studia. A když jsem vůbec poprvé spatřil Shanea McGowana, seděl na biliardovém stole, měl v téhle ruce kytaru a v téhle ruce pintu piva. Určitě to bylo české pivo. A on člověk nikdy neví, když se na něj dívá, co z toho bude, protože je takový nepředvídatelný, takže nevíte, jestli se s váma pozdraví a bude všechno v pohodě, nebo jestli vám vyšplíchne tu pintu do obličeje. A pak jsme se potkali ještě znovu, druhý den, zase přes Viktorii a přeskočila jiskra a vzniklo z toho něco výjimečného a já jsem na to velice pyšný. I když musím říct, že v těch prvních okamžicích, když jsem ho viděla, tak jsem si říkal, pane bože, ten člověk se nedožije 14 dnů. Ten to nedá. A to bylo před 30 lety.
Well done.
Thank God people speak different languages.
My answers from now on will just be yes and no.
Já už od teďka budu odpovídat jenom ano nebo ne.
I don't wish to exhaust you. I'm sorry.
Nechci vás úplně vyčerpat. I think I'll manage. Don't worry.
Julian.
It's a beautiful language, the Czech language, by the way, listening to you.
Mimochodem, čeština je krásný jazyk, když vás tak poslouchám.
Julian, I have a question for you, Julian. Shane je člověk opředený mnoha legendami. Pamatujete si, jaká legenda o něm se vám nejvíce vrala do paměti, než jste jej poznal?
Já mám otázku pro Juliana. Shane is a man surrounded by legends. Which was the very first legend that stayed with you before you actually met him?
Well, the first legend I knew about Shane was the peroxide bottle. You know, every young punk had to get the bottle out and like douse themselves in bleach, right? And Joe Strummer did too much. He looked like Marlon Brando in Julius Caesar. Shane got it kind of about right, you know. And if you remember in the film, there is a shot. There's an interview with Shane, still with the, you know, the baptismal bleached hair of the punk. Very early Shane. When I knew, and I did the first interview with him, when I knew him, you wouldn't know he was Irish, amazingly. Unless you knew his name. I didn't know his name originally. I just thought he was another heavy duty, full on, beautiful London punk, which he is still, I think, although he denies a bit of that. Should I shut up now?
Okay. Já myslím, že ta první věc byla láhev peroxidu. Protože každý punk, který si sám sebe tehdy vážil, se prostě musel polít nějakým takovým peroxidem, něčím podobným a obarvit se na blond. A on to trošku přehnal, vypadal něco jako kříženec Marlena Branda a Julia Cezara. To jste možná viděl i v tom filmu, je tam jeden takový rozhovor, kde ještě je vidět, že má ty své původní blond obarvené vlásky. A já když jsem s ním dělal první rozhovor, tak já jsem vlastně nevěděl, že to Ir. Já jsem v podstatě ani neznal jeho jméno, já jsem jenom věděl, že je to prostě opravdový plnokrevný punk, londýnský punk.
Can I ask a question?
Můžu se zeptat na něco?
Did you like the film?
Líbil se vám film?
Shane hates it.
That's the best answer. That's the best answer yet. Thank you so much.
As a director of the film, I have to say, without Victoria and without Johnny, we wouldn't be here. Ups and downs on the film, and that they stopped the boat from capsizing.
Him.
And Mr. Duters.
Definitely him.
Who's he?
A jako režisér filmu musím říct, že bez Johnnyho a bez Victoria bychom tady nebyli.
Stage.
Keep the microphone, Stephen.
I'm not meant to be here.
Sorry about that.
Bylo to trošku jako na houpačce.
Can we get him to say something?
Yeah, no, I was about to ask him a question.
A samozřejmě se o to taky zasloužil Stephen. A teď se ho na něco zeptáme.
Sorry. Phoning it in.
Stephen. Come
Stephen.
On. First song Stephen? By the Pogues. First song by the Pogues, you remember?
First song.
You heard in your life.
Do you remember any of the songs?
Yeah. První písnička, kterou si pamatujete, jejich první písnička, kterou
Warm up question.
Zahřívací otázka.
First song that you wrote for the Pogues.
Yeah. First song that you wrote for the Pogues. Actually,
can you sing any of the songs? Any of them?
Fiesta.
Crikey. Yeah, Fiesta's a classic.
Okay.
Fiesta.
Give us Fiesta.
No, I don't really have that kind of voice.
Můžeš nám něco zaspívat, třeba Fiestu? Fiesta, to je skvělá písnička. Ne, já myslím, že to nemám hlas.
Sally McLennan, maybe that was the first one I heard. I was quite young.
Can you sing it?
You're very
Sally
young,
McLennan, to jsem byl hodně malý.
In 2 hours, in a bar, somewhere in this town, after a few more wines, I will definitely be singing that song.
Zaspíváte nám i za 2 hodinky, až si dáme pár skleniček vína někde ve vinárně nebo hospůdce, tak vám to zaspívám.
Three.
Johnny, speaking of singing.
Když mluvíme o tom zpěvu, Johnny.
Are you trying to inflict that image into my head?
Snažíme se mi něco vnutit, nějakou myšlenku?
I'm sure he could do it, but I just don't see him doing it. So therefore I feel a strange urge to giggle at the image of it. But what Stephen did was truly, as a producer, no less than miraculous. Because when you're, I think Julian would agree, a documentary or a film of some beast, something, some creature that is a unique creature, it's not going to be an easy ride. It's just not. But it at the same time it shouldn't be an easy ride. I would rather Shane have, you know, hit the moments of non-cooperation, which was his instant.
That was his way of directing the film by proxy.
Exactly. Yeah.
Paint us into a fucking corner and laugh while we were trying to get out of the corner, you know.
But that's, that was the beauty
Shane's
of it.
Shane's film, in a way, you know.
That was the beauty of it. Shane essentially dictated
from afar
what bits he would be involved in and the ones he wouldn't. And so, I mean, that puts a producer and a director in a corner where you have to actually really start to think that I'm trying to capture this animal, this beautiful white tiger.
Snow leopard.
Yeah.
You're trying to capture the snow leopard, and the snow leopard is, he just doesn't feel like cooperating all the time. So it forces you into a corner. Me personally, I think that it's being forced into a corner at times is incredibly healthy for the... Well, for the project, because I think it's nice when the bottom drops out and you don't know what's going to happen. Then you must search, then you have to find, then you have to... So I think Shane did the film a great favor in a weird way.
Great director, Shane McGowan.
Yes.
Ano, já jsem si jistý tím, že on by tu písničku dal, ale nebudeme ho teď trápit. Každopádně jako producent v podstatě udělal něco, co má velice blízko k opravdovému zázraku. A Julian se mnou určitě bude souhlasit, protože natočit dokument o takovémto tvoru, o takovémto jedinečném tvoru, rozhodně není hračka, ona by to ani hračka být neměla. On občas spolupracoval, občas ne, byl v podstatě sám sobě režisérem a sám sobě producentem, a který to celé tak trošku vedl na dálku nebo z rohu. A Shane v podstatě sám diktoval, kdy bude spolupracovat a kdy ne. Takže byl sám také producentem a režisérem. A zachytit a vystihnout takovéto zvíře, takového divokého tygra, takového sněžného geparda, to vůbec není snadné, protože nikdy nevíte, kde bude spolupracovat a kdy ne. A když mě někdo takto občas zatlačí do kouta, ono je to docela zdravé, ono je to docela dobré a prospěšné pro celý ten projekt, protože nevíte, co bude dál a musíte dál hledat. Takže já si myslím, že tomu filmu Shane tímto způsobem hodně prospěl.
I wish I could have said something that beautiful, but I'm sure I didn't.
Já bych si byl přál, abych řekl něco tak krásného, ale určitě jsem to tak neřekl.
Julian, your film world premiered about a year ago at the San Sebastian Film Festival. You got one of the awards. Congratulations. Have you traveled with the film? Did you have a chance to travel a little bit? And how was the reception of the film and of Shane's, how was the Shane's popularity in different countries if you had a chance to travel?
Juliane, váš film měl premiéru zhruba před rokem na festivalu San Sebastiánu, dostali jste také jednu z cen, blahopřejeme. Měli jste šance jezdit s filmem po světě a jakého se mu dostalo přijetí? Jaká byla popularita Shane v různých zemích?
Well, Shane is famous all over the world. Where did we go? San Sebastian, yeah. Spain, very nice, very good. Berlin. But what we really want is to show the film in Ireland, and we haven't been able to do that yet because of the COVID, because that's where it really all begins. But I think Shane is a universal personality, and wherever, I'm sure we made the film to piss certain people off anyway, but where they like Shane, which is all around the world, it's always going to have a good favorable reception, let's put it that way. But it's about an amazing person who's a universal example of living a life. What's possible in one life, which we should all try with our lives to live as many as possible, and Shane's done more than most of us.
Ano, my jsme s tím filmem byli v San Sebastianu, to je pravda, tam byla premiéra, potom jsme byli ve Španělsku, tam to bylo krásné a skvělé, byli jsme v Berlíně, ale hlavně jsme film chtěli promítat v Irsku a to se nám zatím kvůli covidu nepodařilo. A je to proto, protože tam to má všechno svoje počátky. Shane je samozřejmě univerzální osobnost. Ten film jsme natočili mimo jiné, protože jsme chtěli pár lidí naštvat. Nicméně jinak samozřejmě přijetí bylo příznivé, protože Shane je taková úžasná osobnost, je to univerzální příklad toho, co všechno je možné zažít v jednom životě. O tom bychom se měli snažit my všichni prožít těch životů více než jenom jeden. A já myslím, že on nám ukazuje, co je možné.
I think Richard Branson should take Shane on the next flight into space, actually. Then we get a proper view of the world from outside.
Já myslím, že NASA by měla vzít Shane na další let do vesmíru a pak bychom si udělali pořádnou skutečnou představu o tom, jaký ten náš svět je.
Johnny. Let's wrap this up with the funniest, the craziest story you've ever had with Mr. Shane McGovern.
Já myslím, že to uzavřeme nejlegračnější, nejplácnější historkou, kterou jste kdy se Shaneem zažil.
Well, good night, everyone.
Přeji všem dobrý večer.
That's a tough question.
It's really tough.
Těžká otázka.
Really tough.
I'm going through various in my mind. I'm going through various stages of hangover. over 30 plus years. And I will say that in terms of, you know, there's that the gravity of the throbbing gristle in your head with a hangover, you know, the pounding of the brain. That's one thing. That's the weekend. You have that on Monday. I had someone had shot an arrow directly between in this dead center in the middle of my brain from my first days with Shane. The one thing I learned is never ever try to keep up with Shane McGowan or Hunter Thompson for that matter. You don't try to keep up. There was when Shane did, I believe, his first solo record.
The time you blew up the mixing desk, that time. That's funny.
That's the story. She just told it. There it is. That was it. Shane had asked me to come in and you know, play some guitar on a few tracks or whatever, and I was honored, you know. And went there, and he's playing me the tracks, and I don't know, somebody handled me a bottle of white wine that for some reason felt like a relative, and it stayed with me right up until we were listening to the things that we'd recorded, and I was leaning over the recording desk and smashed, accidentally, just sort of this bottle of white wine slipped out of my hands, and it made the most hideous noise, like a crackling of lightning, but with this thunderous kind of effect that just lingered with reverb for about 2 minutes. Shane's eyes got really big. He went, and when it was done, he went, "Did we get that? Did we record that noise?" And they said, "No. Johnny's just blown up the mixing board. See you in a week." And yeah, it's a true story. True story.
Já si teď promítám v hlavě nejrůznější fáze kocoviny, které jsem za těch 30 nebo víc než 30 let zažil. Znáte to, když někde popíte, potom druhý den ráno nebo po víkendu v pondělí, vám buší v hlavě, máte pocit, že se vám hlava rozkočí. Mně se stává, že mám pocit, že mi někdo zarazil šíp úplně přímo doprostřed hlavy, doprostřed mozku. Takové byly moje první dny se Shaneem McGowanem a poučení, které z toho vyplývá, nikdy se nepokoušejte držet krok se Shaneem McGowanem. A jedna taková historka, když natáčel svoje první solové album, požádal mě, abych mu tam zahrál něco na kytaru. Přišli jsme do studia, on mi přehrával, co bych měl hrát na tu kytaru, a nějak se mi dostala do ruky láhe bílého vína. Měl jsem takový pocit, že ke mně patří, a tak se mnou zůstala až do těch okamžiků, kdy jsme si potom přehrávali to, co jsme natočili. A já jsem se opíral o mixážní pult a ta láhev mi vypadla z ruky a rozbila se o ten pult. Vyvolalo to příšerný zvuk, hromy, blesky, trvalo to asi 2 minuty a já jsem strnul a Shane strnul, vyvalil oči a říká, máme to. Chytli jsme ten zvuk. A někdo mu řekl, ne, protože Johnny právě rozbil mixážní pult.
Well, thank you very, very much. Please give our love and warmest regards to Mr. Shane McGowan. And thank you for coming to Kailua to introduce this wonderful movie.
Did you have a message for Shane? We could send it back to him.
Můžeme poslat Shaneovi nějakou nebo nahrát Shaneovi nějakou zprávu?
Hold on.
Mario, come.
For Shane, yeah? Pro Shane.